hanging out with you today. Now, speaking of church, that is exactly what we're talking about this month. We are starting a brand new series called We Are the Church. And I love this because over the next few weeks, we're going to be learning all about how the church isn't the building that we're standing in, but it's about the people. It's about you. It's about me. It's about all of us because we are the church. Now, if you were listening to Pastor Paul this morning, you heard that that's exactly what he was talking about. Now, he was also talking about something pretty cool called the five commitments, and those are worship, grow, belong, serve, and share. Now, kids, these are not just for grown-ups, but the five commitments, these are important for you guys too, because when you guys learn what these are all about and you learn how to live them out in your own life, that will help you know and become like Jesus, and that's super cool. So before we start our lesson, I want to test your knowledge and see what you already know about the five commitments. So here we go. I'm going to ask you a question, and you need to pick the one answer that does not belong. All right, you ready? Here we go. Here is your first question. Which one of these does not describe belong? Is it the monkey praying with a friend when they're having a bad day? The cat keeping a bee in a jar for a long time? A pig reading the Bible together as a family? Or the cow singing worship music around a campfire with your friends? All right, which is it? The monkey, cat, pig, or cow? Cat, yes, if you pick cat, you are correct. Belong is not keeping a bee in a jar for a long time. It is, though, praying, reading your Bible, or worshiping with friends, because belong is all about connecting with other people. All right, second question, here we go. Which one of these does not describe worship? Is it the monkey doing what is right with a joyful heart? The cat spending time praying and talking to God? The pig singing praise songs to Jesus? Or the cow having a bad attitude while you're helping your dad? All right, which is it? Monkey, cat, pig, or cow? If you picked the cow, marvelous job, that is correct. Worship is not having a bad attitude when you're helping your dad. But worship is things like doing what's right, singing praises, or spending time praying and talking to God, because worship is anything that we do that shows God worth. All right, question number three, here we go. Which one of these does not describe serve? Is it the monkey telling your brother to do your chores? The cat helping your neighbor with yard work? The pig helping your sister with schoolwork? Or the cow delivering groceries to someone who can't leave their house? Monkey, cat, pig, or cow? What's your pick? If you pick the monkey, you are correct. It is not telling your brother to do your chores. But serve is helping neighbors, helping your family, or helping people in your community. Because serving is all about wholeheartedly doing what we can to help the people around us. All right, question number four, here we go. Which one of these does not describe share? Is it the monkey inviting a friend to church? The cat letting your brother use your new bike because his tire is flat? The pig sharing bad things about someone else to a friend? Or the cow sharing your favorite Bible verses with a friend? All right, what's your pick? Monkey, cat, pig, or cow? It's the pig. If you guess the pig, you are correct. This is not what share is all about. But share is sharing with friends, sharing with your family, or sharing others. Sharing is using our words and our actions to tell other people about Jesus. All right, last question, here we go. Which of these does not describe grow? Is it the monkey making sure you eat all your vegetables? The cat reading my Bible? The pig watching church online? Or the cow praying and talking to God? All right, which is it? Monkey, cat, pig, or cow? That's right, if you pick the monkey, you are correct. Growing is not making sure you eat your vegetables. Now, how many of you guys just cheered really loudly at that? But grow is reading your Bible, watching church online, and praying. It's anything that we do that helps us learn and become more like Jesus. That's what grow is all about. Now, guys, what is so cool about these five commitments is that these aren't things that just we do today, but these are things that the early church did way back when they first started. In fact, that's what our Bible story is all about. See, Miss Haley and Mr. Shannon are going to be coming here in just a second to tell us today's Bible story in a very, well, all right, I'll be honest. I don't really know how to describe exactly what they're going to do. You're just going to have to watch it yourself. All right, take a look.
This week, and we have a great story from the Bible in Acts chapter 2, and it's all about the early church. And they didn't have a building, but they did have the Holy Spirit.
We got the power!
Now, it says this: the believers spent their time listening to the teaching of the apostles.
That's great! They were learning about Jesus.
Now, they shared everything with each other.
That's belong! They were like in community with their best buds, eating all their food together and talking about Jesus.
Yeah, and they ate together and they prayed together.
That's worship. Praying together is worship.
Many wonders and miraculous signs were happening through the apostles, and everyone felt great respect for God.
That's serve. They were helping and caring for other people just like Jesus would.
All the believers stayed together and shared everything.
That's belong with all their buddies and Jesus.
Yeah. They sold their land and the things they owned. Then they divided the money and they gave it to those who needed it.
That's served. They served by selling their land because they were reflections of Jesus. And they were sharing. They gave the people exactly what they needed.
Now, the believers shared a common purpose, and every day they spent much of their time together in the temple area.
That's growing! In the temple area, they were learning about God.
They also ate together in their homes, and they were happy to share their food and ate with joyful hearts.
That's belong! That's belong! They were with all of their close friends, their buddy buds. They were eating food and talking together.
Now, the believers praised God and were respected by all the people.
Oh, that's worship! Singing praises to God.
More and more people were being saved every day, and the Lord was adding them to their group.
That's sure! All of their attitudes and the way that they reflected Jesus was amazing. I mean, who doesn't want to be friends with a guy who acts Jesus.
Absolutely. You know what, Miss Haley? They were acting out the five commitments. Yeah, what are they again?
Worship, grow, belong, serve, share.
Here, there, and everywhere. That's awesome.
Let's do it!
All right, and here's Miss Erica to tell you how you can do it this week.
All right, kids, see, I told you, there was no good way to describe that story. But wasn't it so awesome how the first church lived out worship, grow, belong, serve, share, here, there, and everywhere? I mean, it was so cool. Now, guys, this is your challenge. You guys are going to join the grown-ups, and over the next 40 days, we're going to challenge you to live out the five commitments. Now, we've got tons of great ways for you to do that on our website. So kids, grab a grown-up, go to our webpage, and check it out. And while you're there, don't forget to check out all the other great activities that we've got for you. All right, remember, we are the church. Let's do it!